Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to skew footage in Adobe Premiere Pro. And this is really similar to like free distort, change perspective, or free transform if you're used to Adobe Photoshop or Illustrator. Now, what I mean is if you have footage like this, let's say it's flat lay footage, for example, and this rectangle is not really a rectangle, and we want it to be more of a rectangle like this. So that's what I mean. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I have my footage on the timeline here. Now you can see that this line is not exactly parallel with the edge of the screen. It's going kind of up and in, and this side is too. Right now I'm in the Essentials workspace, and I'm going to change to Editing. Editing is the one I usually use. Then I'll come down here to the Project window, and I'm going to choose the little flyout and go to Effects. I'll search for Corner Pin, and here it is right here. So I'm going to click and drag this onto my footage. Now that won't change anything, but then I get this little Corner Pin effect right up here in my Effect Controls. So now I can move these sliders and see how it affects my image. I'm going to choose the upper left, and then I'm going to pull it to the left a little bit. That's not really doing what I want. But when I change the right side one, I'm getting it a little more straight on the left side here. So this is looking really good right now. Now I'll come down here to lower left, and we'll see what we can do here. And lower right. In my experience, you just kind of have to mess with these until you get a result you like. At least that's what I've always done. Okay, now this looks really nice. I'm going to move it over to the left a little bit. But visually, this is more of a square now instead of some kind of polygon. You can also turn on your guides. Click up here in the program window and then hit Command R or Control R to turn on the guides. Then click on a ruler and drag over to get a guide and place it, and then put it right alongside the edge so you can see how square it is. I like to do this at the end after I visually do it. I find these to be a little distracting. You can hit Command Semicolon or Control Semicolon to turn those off and on. And if you want to get rid of them completely, you can go to View, Clear Guides, and that's it. All right, I hope this video is helpful. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.